Philippine tycoon Henry C. Jr. partners with U.S. tech mogul Elon Musk to provide satellite broadband service in the Philippines. The data lake company, partly owned by C, will become the first Starlink integrator in the Philippines and in Southeast Asia. Starlink is the satellite internet service of the SpaceX company owned by Musk. Its constellation of satellites can provide internet connectivity to remote areas even during natural disasters. Data Lake Chairman Anthony Almeida says Starlink's over 2,300 low Earth orbit satellites can connect the Philippine archipelago to the rest of the world. Starlink's broadband service in the Philippines will be offered to businesses and government offices.
Now here are some economic events we're monitoring. This Friday, Singapore will release its third quarter jobs data. Singapore's unemployment rate dropped to 2.1% in the April to June period, the lowest jobless rate since the third quarter of 2018, as the economy's recovered further from COVID disruptions. The Bank of Japan policy will announce its latest policy decision. The central bank is expected to raise its inflation forecasts, but keep ultra-low interest rates steady in a show of resolve to support the fragile economy. And Germany will come out with its October inflation figures. Consumer prices in Germany jumped to a new record high of 10% in September, highlighting the impact of the ongoing energy crisis. President Marcos thanks China for being a dependable partner in government's infrastructure push as he led the groundbreaking ceremony for the Davao-Samar Bridge project. Pia Gutierrez reports.
The construction of a 4-kilometer bridge that will connect Davao City to the popular tourist destination Samal Island formally breaks ground in Davao City. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. himself led the ceremonies Thursday for the Samal Island-Davao City Connector Bridge project. Once completed, the bridge is expected to shorten travel time between Davao City and Samal Island from around 30 minutes via ferry to only 5 minutes by land.
In 2027, this bridge will surely ease the convenience of travel and transport, bringing forth gainful opportunities for many of our people by providing a link between relatively far-flung areas and economic centers. Thereby, we ensure smoother mobility of people and of goods.
In his speech, Marcos Jr. thanked the Chinese government for being a dependable partner for the infrastructure program. Not only will the construction be handled by state-owned China Road and Bridge Corporation, 90% of the 23 billion peso funding will come from a loan agreement from China.
This is a testament to the strong and ever-growing foundation of the bilateral relations and cooperation between our two countries. It is always a pleasure as a nation to join hands with you for the eventual success of this endeavor.
I wish that both sides would join hands to secure on time and high quality completion of this project, and the project will be, as we believe, a new passage of to a better livelihood of the local people, a new landmark of the region of Davao, and a new milestone of the China-Philippines friendship.
Marcos also made sure to acknowledge the Duterte administration for the bridge project, as he clarified that it was his predecessor who started the project in 2018.
I am only fortunate to have been sitting as president when we broke ground for this very important project. This project actually was formally begun by then Secretary Mark Villar under the Duterte administration, and it began formally to put together the project since 2018. So the previous administration had already been working on this project for 4 years before we arrived to this day. However, I am looking forward to also once again being the lucky one to open the bridge when it is finished.
The president also distributed financial aid to several Davao City residents, including some 500 individuals who received 5,000 pesos from the DSWD. At the AFP's Eastern Mindanao Command headquarters in Davao City, Marcos Jr. led a formal declaration by authorities that the entire Davao region is finally free from communist insurgents.
Honored and pleased to declare pursuant to the Regional Peace and Order Council Resolution Number 7, dated October 12, 2022, that the entire Region 11, comprising of Davao del Norte, Davao del Sur, Davao de Oro, Davao Oriental, Davao Occidental, and City of Davao, as an insurgency-free region. Ang makasaysayang tagumpay na ito ay isang patunay na kayang supilin ng sambayanang Pilipino ang anumang salot o banta sa kapayapaan at kaunlaran ng ating bayan.
In his speech in front of military soldiers, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. expressed gratitude to the sacrifices and heroism of uniformed personnel in the government's victory against communist insurgents in the region. He also credited the controversial National Task Force to End Local Communist Conflict, or NTF-LCAC, for its whole-of-nation approach to peace in ending the communist insurgency.
We can say that the armed forces, the uniformed forces in our country, your mission has shifted. It has changed a little bit. Whereas before we asked you to be war fighters, now we ask you to be bringers of peace. And the success of the NTF-LCAC program and all of the efforts of our military, of our police, have shown in the reaping of the benefits that we celebrate today that the Davao provinces are insurgency-free.
Marcos Jr. also announced the relaunch of the Davao region as a tourism and investment-ready destination, saying that the region can now finally see continuous progress with the improvement of its peace and order situation. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.